Okay, yesterday we had discussed about urine formation. Generally, urine formation is occurs in within three steps. One is ultrafiltration, second one is selectively reabsorption, and third one is renal secretions or renal reabsorptions and renal secretion. The urine formation occurs in within three steps. Now what we are going to discuss? Now we are going to discuss about chemical composition of urine. Okay, what is our concept? Composition of urine. Composition of urine. Composition of urine. Okay, what is the meaning of composition of urine? The meaning of composition means for in urine, what type of chemical compounds, what type of materials is there in urine, what type of organic, inorganic substances, and what is the color of urine. That means the detail, what are the mineral, what are the materials are having in urine. So that is we can call composition of urine, chemical composition of urine. Generally, chemical composition, that means, we have to discuss about the chemical composition of urine. Urine, every time it will be not comes in what same color, sometimes what pale color, light yellow, sometimes what dark, dark yellowish color. Chemical composition of urine depend upon their food material. That means, depend upon food and fluids consumed by the individuals. Okay, the composition is depend upon, composition is depend upon consumed food, whatever they are taking, consumed food and fluids, fluids, based on chemical composition. The chemical composition, what is the meaning of chemical composition of urine? In urine, what type of materials, what type of substances having in urine? In urine, generally, urine is based on their food, based on consumed food, based on what type of fluids they are taking. So, if they are not taking what, especially for not drinking proper water, urine will be concentrated. More concentrated. If they take what more water, plenty of water, it will urine will be normal. So, here the important point is what? The chemical composition is based on their consumed food and fluids. Consumed food, understand. Consumed food and fluids, these are the chemical composition is depend upon. That is the materials, whatever materials having in urine, that is based on their food and whatever fluids they are taking in. So in a daily, in a healthy person, how much of urine he excretes? Amount means amount of urine he excretes, he or she, in individuals excrete in a day 1.2 to 1.5 liters of urine. 1.5 liters of urine in a day. 1.2 to 1.5 liters of urine in a day. I am saying about only healthy person, not for diabetes and not for other diseases who are having other diseases. But I am explaining about what who are healthy person, they excrete in a day only 1.5 liters approximately. Okay, any healthy person, they excrete from their body. So pH value of urine, pH value of urine. Sometimes urine is what, acidic in nature, sometimes base. Sometimes acidic means what, 4.8 to 7.5. Okay, 7.5. So what is this pH value? The pH value is the hydrogen concentration in urine. based on hydrogen concentration, urine concentration is there. Urine is hypotonic or hypertonic. What is hypotonic and hypertonic? I will explain. Based on hypotonic and hypertonic urine, hyper means highly concentrated urine. Based on their pH value also. pH value is below 7, that is what acidic already you know. Above 7, that is base. Okay, so the pH value is what? The urine pH value is 4.82, especially for 7.5. So, okay, it is sometimes acidic and sometimes in base. Okay, and what color is that? This is very, very important. Color. Okay, urine color. Generally, urine is for pale yellowish color. So, which color is then normal? Generally, urine is pale yellowish color. Yellowish color is there. So, why it is pale yellowish color? This is very, very important for NEET. Okay, why it is yellowish color? In the, okay, one pigment is there. That pigment name is urochrome. Urochrome. What is urochrome? Okay, actually urochrome is made up of what? Okay, especially for dead RBC or okay hemoglobin, whatever word, broken hemoglobin, hemoglobin HB, and dead RBCs are formed. Dead RBC means what? Red blood cells are urochrome. So urine is yellowish color. Why urine is yellowish color? In that one pigment is there. The pigment ka naam kya hai? The pigment ka name, that is what? Urochrome. Urochrome is made up of okay RBC, broken RBC, broken RBC, dead RBC, and broken what? Hemoglobin is what? Broken and forms what? Urochrome. Let's try to remember what, especially for urochrome, is the cause of pale yellowish color of urine. And same smell. Okay, if you observe the smell of urine, what type of smell is there in urine? Generally, urine smell we can call aromatic. Aromatic means what? That is a concentrated smell. That is a base sudan urine. Sometimes it is acidic, sometimes in basic base. So base sudan urine composition. Okay, sometimes it gives more smell, sometimes very less smells only. So that smell we can call aromatic smell. Okay, aromatic smell due to urine odor. Smell due to urine odor. Yes, very, very important. What is urine odor? That is a bacterial, okay, the bacterial infection, the bacterial, okay, the bacteria is what, especially for converters, it will decompose and bacteria forms what? Some types of smell. That smell is cause of what? Urine odor. Urine odor. Which type of smell is there? Aromatic smell. Aromatic smell. And specific gravity. If you observe the urine specific gravity. Specific gravity of urine. What is the meaning here? Gravity. Gravity means what? The weight. Weight. Especially for urine molecules weight. 1.04. Okay, 1.04 slightly heavier than water. Slightly heavier than water. Here the word given, what here given? Specific gravity. Here the gravity means of weight of the urine molecules in urine substance. Compared with water, it is little bit heavier, which is urine. The gravity is 1.032. Urine gravity is 1.032, 1.04. Okay, try to remember. Okay, so next one, organic constituent. What type of what organic materials is there? Organic substances in urine. In urine, what type of organic substances is there? Urea. And so what type of organic substances? Urea. Okay, urea, 25% of urea, and uric acid. यूरिक एसिड अप्रोक्सिमेटली इन यूरिन यूरिक एसिड 0.622 grams of what? Uric acid. And creatinine is the substance of what? When the muscular proteins are broken, muscular protein, it is a coming from what? Muscular protein. Creatinine 1.5 grams. 1.5 grams. And also what? Oxalic acid. Oxalic acid. Oxalic acid. 0.0015 grams. Very less oxalic acid. 0.015 grams, and after that one 0.015 grams, after that one what? Glucose. Actually glucose is nil. Very important. Why the glucose is nil? Nil means what? There is no glucose in the healthy person urine. Why? Because glucose is nil in healthy person urine means what? Glucose is 100% of glucose is reabsorbed in PCT only. So glucose is nil. But in diabetes patient, in their urine, glucose, they lost some glucose from their body. So here in healthy person, glucose is nil, especially if these are the chemical composition and some more inorganic substances also in there in urine. Inorganic substances. What are inorganic substances? Inorganic substances are inorganic substances are water, compulsory up to 98% of water only is there. Okay, water and 96% of water and NaCl. NaCl means what? Sodium chloride. Okay, based on food material, NaCl 2.5 grams to 6 grams, 2.5 grams to 6 grams of NaCl, 6 grams of NaCl, and some more potash, calcium, okay, calcium is 2.9% 9 grams, and ammonia, generally ammonia also is there, sometimes what? 0.05 to 0.07 grams. What are these? Are inorganic substances in that urine? What we are discussing, composition of urine. What is the meaning of composition of urine? In urine, what type of substances is there in urine? What type of material it will be consist to? What type of materials in urine we are discussing? So, okay, in urine, especially organic substances, in inorganic substances, and abnormal, sometimes what? In unhealthy person, glucose, albumin, RBCE. So, abnormal constituents. Abnormal means what? Especially for some, disease, who are having disease, abnormal constituents. Okay, what are the abnormal constituents is there? Abnormal constituents are what? Glucose, albumin, and amino acid, and bile ketone bodies, and microbes, and pus, etc. So, I am giving the detailed information about what urine, composition of urine. That means in urine, what type of substances is there in urine. If you have in front of you, already I have told in front of you, keep one notebook and try to take down the substance and detailed information of what chemical composition of urine. Now, what we are going to discuss? Now, we are going to discuss about what role of kidney in asthma regulation. Okay, our concept is what right now? Role of kidney in asthma regulation. So, I will make a line between role of kidney in asthma regulation. Here the word given, okay, role of kidney in asthma regulation. What is the meaning of asthma regulation? Asthma regulation means simply, asthma means water and salts, what balancing the regulating or balancing the water and salts in our body. It is balancing the kidney. The main function of kidney is what? It is balancing asthma regularity. The meaning of asthma regularity, okay, especially for the kidney, playing an important role in maintaining water and asthmatic concentration. So the kidney play very important role. What it plays important role in maintaining what it maintains? It maintains water and asthmatic concentration, water and salts concentration. Even it maintains the sodium concentration also. Not only water, it maintains the sodium concentration also. So the important, the main role of kidney is what? Maintaining. What it maintains? Water and salts concentration. That is, we can call asthma regulation. The meaning of asthma regulation means what? It is balancing. Asthma means generally in water. Regulation means balancing the water content, water percentage in our body, and after that one it is sending outside the body. So, okay, especially for it excretes sometimes dilute urine. It excretes sometimes dilute urine. Okay, when it is excretes dilute urine, okay, when the water is abundant in the body. Try to understand what is the concept I am writing here. We are discussing about how kidney play very important role in asthma regularity. That is our concept name. What is the meaning of asthma regularity? Balancing the water. Are you observed or not in our daily life? In our daily life, sometimes we excrete more urine. When we excrete, for example, in rainy season, in winter season, we are drinking less water. One concept. Why we are drinking less water? Why we are at there in outside in atmosphere, temperature is normal or less temperature. So our body is not losing any water through with water evaporation. Very less in winter and rainy season, so that we excrete more urine, dilute urine. What is the meaning of dilute? More water is there in that urine. Try to understand what are we discussing. In summer season, if you observe it, then in summer season, we excrete very less urine, one concept, and concentrated urine, less urine. So these two concepts. Why? Because our body already evaporates.
by the process of evaporation, we lost lot of water as a sweat. So what happened? The kidneys are what kidneys especially for reabsorb the water. So it excrete what concentrated and less urine only. This is the point very, very important. Why it excrete less urine in summer, especially in sometimes based on body fluids. If the body fluid, here the word given what? It excretes sometimes dilute urine. Dilute means what? More water. Dilute urine, when the water is abundant in the body, sufficient water is there in the body. In our body, at the time of rainy season and winter season, in our body, sufficient water is there. Whatever water is required for metabolic, normal water percentage is there in our body. That time we excrete more urine. But, okay, sometimes we excrete. It excretes, it means what kidney excretes, what sometimes it excretes concentrated urine. When it is excreted, especially in the well in our body, so that I will write that one also. When the water percentage less in our body, body fluids are less, at the time it excrete concentrated urine. So you have to remember which time they excrete concentrated urine, which time it excrete what? Based on body fluids. What is the meaning of body fluid? Based on water and salts percentage in our body. If in our body dehydration, salt percentage is very less, sometimes what will be happen? When the salt percentage is very less in our body, automatically salt and water percentage, we excrete concentrated urine, who are healthy persons. Why we excrete concentrated urine? That is the concept is very, very important. Why we excrete concentrated urine means for at the time when the body fluids are less in our body. So I will write the detailed information here. Later you have to take down whatever given information on board. Okay. When body fluids
are less in our body, when the body fluids are less in our body, at the time in our body, our brain, that is a neurohyphosis, a neurohypophysis secretes one hormone. The hormone name is ADH means for antidiuretic hormone or vasopressin hormone. Try to understand what I am explaining here. Our brain is releasing secrets
for antidiuretic hormone, ADH. Antidiuretic hormone are also called vasopressin hormone. At the time when the body fluids are less, this is the reason. When the body fluids are less in our body, at the time what body fluids are not sufficient in our body, water content is less in our body, salts concentration less in our body, at that time what happened? The brain, pituitary gland is there, okay. And the pituitary gland and second part of the pituitary gland, neurohypophysis. Okay, the neurohypophysis secretes one hormone. That hormone name is antidiuretic hormone or ADH hormone and vasopressin hormone. What is the use of vasopressin hormone? This vasopressin hormone is useful to what? Reabsorption. It is useful to what it is doing? It reabsorbs the water. especially it is releasing in DCT, we absorb the water, whatever water is entered into the DCT, distal convoluted tubule, it is reabsorbed the water again from, okay, it is a secreting in blood, enter into the kidneys from peritabular capillaries to, it is entered into the renal tubule and it is useful to reabsorption of water. So at the time we excrete what concentrated urine. So when we are excreted concentrated urine,
when we are excreted concentrated urine means what? When the when in our body fluids are less, at the time our brain, our neurohypophysis is secreting one hormone. That hormone name is antidiuretic hormone or vasopressin hormone. That vasopressin hormone, antidiuretic hormone, is useful to reabsorption of what? Reabsorption of water. Again, it is sending the water into the body. So, okay, and one more important point. If antidiuretic hormone or vasopressin hormone is not secreting, it is not secreting, which is ADH, is not secreting, or vasopressin is not secreting, what happened? It is a cause of, they lost lot of water from their body. That type of situation, that type of disease, we can call diabetes insipidus. What we call that is diabetes insipidus. Diabetes insipidus. What is diabetes insipidus? Very, very important. Diabetes insipidus is the word disease. Okay, they lost a lot of water from their body. If ADH, if vasopressin is not releasing in proper way, insufficient secretions of vasopressin or antidiuretic hormone, ADH hormone, cause of diabetes insipidus. They excrete, they are sending outside the body more water, more urine. They lost lot of water from their body. It is indirectly cause of sometimes dehydration. So that is what importance of ADH hormone. Okay, one concept is important, especially for what is the role of kidney in asthma regularity and asthma relief. In asthma relief means what? The balancing the water and salts concentration in our body, that is we can call asthma regulation or asthma relief. Here asthma regularity and asthma concept, asthma relief, especially for based on atmospheric conditions also. Sometimes in winter and rainy season we excrete dilute urine, more urine or dilute urine. In summer season what we excrete, what concentrated urine. In summer season in our body fluids are very less. At the time our brain is secreting ADH hormone or vasopressin hormone. That vasopressin hormone, ADH hormone, is useful for what? Especially reabsorption of whatever water is entered into the urine. It is useful to reabsorption into the body. So that is very, very important. If it is not secreting proper way, it is a cause of what? Diabetes insipidus. Don't, two types of diabetes is the sugar disease. You can call sugar disease. Sugar disease, two types of diabetes insipidus, diabetes mellitus is there. But this is diabetes insipidus. Okay. The cause of insufficient secretion of what? Vasopressin and antidiuretic hormone. Okay. Next one, not only that one. And sodiums also, regulation of sodium. Already I told what some salts also require to the body. So regulation of sodium. Sodium is reabsorbed under the influence of aldosterone. Sodium is also reabsorbed. At the time when that you are when it is reabsorbed, sodium is reabsorbed means what? And when our body sodiums are required, the molecules of sodium is very less. At the time what will be happened? It is reabsorbed under the influence of aldosterone. The hormone is releasing one hormone, aldosterone. This aldosterone is useful. Aldosterone is useful to reabsorption of sodium. So in our body, kidney play very important role to osmolarity. Okay, so try to remember and try to take down the points whatever given: urine composition of urine and the role of what kidney in osmolarity. Okay, now and next we will discuss after 5 minutes, we will discuss next concept. Okay.